treating you so far?
It is amazing.
It is.
Come on, guys. Where's the clap? Is it okay? Is it awesome?
It's awesome. It's pretty intense. I mean, okay, so in this journey, which is like not even quite a year old since we've been exposed to Stranger Things, I know you guys are doing these shows. Have you had those experiences of seeing people dressed up as you, as your characters? In fact, I see a lot of hats in the audience right now that are somewhat familiar. Is it a little bit surreal when you see people dressed as characters from the show that you are on?
Now I'm a little bit, I'm not used to it because I don't see too many Lucases.
Mm-hmm.
I see a lot of Dustins, so I'm like, Dustin. But but it's kind of cool though, because like people like fell in love with the show,
mm-hmm.
and then like they take time to just do these awesome costumes, so yeah, it's awesome.
Cool. Yeah. Woohoo!
Like me, like they respect my work and stuff. So when I see them, I'm like, "Hey, thank you." It really is like it hits me. It hits me in emotions.
Well, there's also been this this excellent wave of merchandise that has come out surrounding Stranger Things. Funko Pops, action figures, t-shirts, all that cool stuff. But I'm curious about like the Funko Pops or like the figures that have come out. First off, do you guys have those, and where are they displayed? Where are you showing, let's say, the Funko Pops of your characters?
Actually, yeah, they had all of the Stranger Things pop figures sent to us because we all got all of them.
Yeah.
I don't know where. I think mine are in my apartment in Atlanta right now.
Mm-hmm.
Mine are on my desk.
Like surrounded by what? Is there any other cool things on your desk that is next to you?
My pick, as I say, my mirror.
Okay.
My black dresser.
I was sort of thinking another action figure, but comb is also a good answer. Also.
Oh, my SAG award.
Well, I mean, speaking of SAG, like that, you know, MTV Movie Awards, a lip sync battle, like, what's been the craziest sort of exposure that you've already had? Like, going on to one of these other shows, going on to an award show, what's been the most exciting for you so far?
I think what, like, it got really exciting is when we got to perform at the Emmys. We got the same old town fun. That was fun. That was fun. Whoa! It seems like a long time ago.
It's
not really.
That means it's moving right back up again.
I know, but a year isn't that much. Yes, but it's still a short amount of time when you think about it.
Yeah. It's a fairly, I'm going to side with him on this. It seems like a fairly short amount of time.
I think we can talk about that. The grand scale of history. It's a short amount of time. And that's good. I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I mentioned the lip sync battle. Talk a little bit about that. Because it was a really good performance that you both gave. You did LL Cool J, right? And then you did Train.
Yes.
Talk a little bit about the selection of those songs and why those songs.
Why? Well, if you're going on a show, the host is LL Cool J. Why not do a song? I couldn't really find any other song because all the songs that people did on Lip Sync Battle, I couldn't do. So I was like, oh crap, what song could I do? What song could I do? And they recommended me one at first. They wanted me to do I'm going back to Cali, but it was just too slow, so I needed to pump up the volume. My parents was like, oh, have you heard Bad? I'm like, what's that? So I heard it. I was like, oh, yeah. I get to take off my shirt, too. So that's one of the reasons why.
All right. How about you, Gary?
I remember that the reason I picked the song is because I was just looking through saw that there. I'm like, oh, that song is pretty cool. And, you know, that was really funny. No, but I remember, I think that because I remember, I was at my Grandma Claire's house, and my sister was, like, obsessed with it. We were singing it in the guest room of the house, and we listened to it, like, 30 times in a row, and I'm like, hey, I'm going to sing that because it's hilarious.
Good answer.
Yeah, it was just a fun song, and I remember singing with my sister and my brother.
Well, it was fun to watch. All right, let's go ahead and throw it to the audience. I'm going to start right over here. Hi there.
Hello.
Hola.
Bonjour.
This might be a bit cliche, but what was your biggest challenge with knowing Stranger Things?
Definitely some parts of challenges, just like the emotion in first season, like how Lucas went through all these changes. Like, he was happy in the beginning playing D&D, then his friends were missing, he was confused, then he was like really emotional, then got really angry, screaming at everyone.
Stranger Things.
Just little questions. What? Just scream. So, and then he was really. and then he became friends with Eleven, and then he was just emotional that she like left and went somewhere and disappeared into thin air. And so I think that was the most challenging part because I didn't see
acting.
Right to me. Yeah, that was the most challenging part because of you lost my.
I think I sound like that.
Sound like your rep sings.
Yeah, bro.
No, but sorry. Okay. Yeah. So that was
okay. For me, the most challenging part.
Okay. That was the most challenging part because I didn't see anyone play Lucas, and I was the first person to experience Lucas. So I had to see like how was he angry, how was he happy, how was he sad. So that was like the challenging part, not acting.
Acting's challenging too, man.
It is. How you said it was like a roast. What the hell?
Like, you were like, oh, I can talk for you.
I didn't
get that. Okay, let me suck it up.
Alright, you're up. Okay, what was the hardest part for you?
Hardest part. Oh, man. It's hard. It's probably gonna be. Inconsistency with the schedule because, you know, we never really had like an actual routine because we would like start filming at like 5:00 p.m. one day and then start filming at like 7 a.m. like a few days later. It's like there's no like routine, so you really don't know when you're gonna sleep or whatever. But the schedule can be a little crazy at times, but that's probably challenging. Also acting. What?
All right, well, moving on. Let's take another one over here. Hi.
Hi. Were the costumes uncomfortable, like, in any way? Was it hard to act in them?
No.
Nope.
I think it was because it was, like, freezing at the time. We weren't, like, too, like, uncomfortable in them, but, like, I would say just the environment was pretty like hard to like really like concentrate because it was like at some parts like it was freezing, like I couldn't really feel my hands would curl up like the lady in the Wizard of Oz. Like, I'm like, oh crap.
That's never a good sign.
Yeah, it's not. So that's probably like the hardest part, but the costumes were pretty awesome. I like them.
Corduroys are my favorite thing. No, they're so comfy. They are. No, they're just like so soft. It's like the material they feel on the outside, the same thing on the inside. It's like, okay. And they look awful.
think I've ever heard someone speak so highly of corduroy. But you're making me a fan. I'm like, man, I gotta get some corduroy pants. Like, yeah. Not really.
They feel like gym pants, but they're not.
People always hear you coming though when you're wearing corduroys, don't they? They make a lot of noise.
What? What do you plan on doing with wearing corduroy? But people are coming. It's like, okay, you're being
terrible ninja wear is all I'm saying.
I'm not doing anything, but
I'm questioning everything.
Hi, I'm Caitlin.
Hi, Caitlin. That's my sister's name.
Oh, that's a good name.
Is it a C or a K?
It's a C. Is it I-N or Y-N?
C-A-I-T-L-Y-N.
Okay. I'm an I, but it's still awesome.
Super awesome.
Anyway, we know that D&D plays a huge role in Stranger Things, so I was curious, if you were to play in real life, what character would you play as and why?
I don't know. I'm sorry. I have no idea. I have no idea who I would play.
And you mean like what type of...
Yeah,
but
just like the...
So why don't you give us a couple examples? See, you didn't think this question through, did you?
No.
You didn't research it.
No, they're great. It's a great question. It's just weird.
It's a D&D
handbook. Look at that! we are uneducated in the art of D&D, guys. What's that say? I'm not gonna lie.
Guys, it makes me feel bad.
That's when the panel went downhill, guys. Look, maybe we should get another question instead. Hi there.
What was your favorite scene to film and why?
Good question.
My favorite scene to film was when me and this kid were like arguing back and forth, because isn't it funny? Like we're like the comedic duo, like even outside of acting. Like as you guys can tell. Like, right?
Right? Yeah, no, it was not where you were just getting you cool. No, I like filming the scene by the quarry where I got a knife up to my neck.
That's fun.
It was freezing outside, and I felt bad for Finn because when we were running down the hill, he fell on the frozen gravel, scratched up his hand. Mm. It was funny at first. Then I realized, ow. Yeah, that was a fun feature film. There was a lot of action, and I don't run. So that was quite a challenge for me.
My favorite scene was getting thrown up against the hood of a bus. I mean, the hood of a car. Yeah. That was super fun because it was like six different shots that I was thrown to the ground. I did all my stunts. Superman, just like that. I had a scream. Thanks, bro.
What?
You were like helping me, like, just like doing it with me. And, it was super cool. I was dragged on the ground in like the freezing cold, like negative 200. It was freezing.
It was cold.
Yeah,
I'll give you that.
Negative 200 degrees.
Hi, this question is for Gaten. I found it interesting that you were in Les Mis as a little kid on Broadway, and then in Stranger Things, and I wanted to see what the difference was in between acting in front of a live audience and acting in front of a camera.
Well, this could actually work for me and Caleb, because though I was in Les Mis, Caleb was in The Lion King on Broadway. Routine in Broadway, it is only a routine. You do the same thing every night, over and over again. So I mean, and you gotta get it right every time, or else you just gotta keep going with it. I remember I messed up this one time. I ran out on stage, and I was supposed to be like this and start singing to certain people in the audience, but I forgot what I was supposed to say. So I ran out, and I wasn't supposed to be singing, I wasn't singing, so I ran out and go, start doing the actions, I'm doing everything that I'm supposed to do, I'm doing the choreography, I'm walking down the stage and pointing at people, but I'm just... of that happening, I remembered what I was supposed to say, but it was too late because I was supposed to run off stage by then. And so that was stressful. But that was different. When you do that on camera, they just laugh at you and you do it again. When you're on stage, they laugh at you but you keep going. But that was definitely a challenge. It is a different type of acting. It's a whole different experience.
Yeah, Caleb, add to that.
It's a totally different experience. Like, you're on stage, you bust your knee open, keep going.
Whoa, what?
did that actually happen?
Close. I actually was like lifted up in the air, and then I fell on my knee, and then I didn't kept going up, and my knee was bruised. But hey, I'm still here, right?
Someone's not like that.
I had like moments like Ian, like where I just forgot a line. I was supposed to say, I forgot a line. I forgot, and I was supposed to say a line. You know, who knows Lion King? Who knows Lion King?
Woo!
Everyone, some people, and so I was supposed to say, when I'm king, that would be the first thing to go. Right? I'm supposed to say that. I put my hand over Nala right there. And I look at Zazu. And I'm just looking at him. I'm standing there for about 2 minutes. So I'm just like, you be Nala.
Okay.
And then the Nala next to me is like, whispers in my ear, and then I'm like, I just went through a moment because I had so many awesome experiences on set, but so it's like totally different.
It's fine.
Yeah.
Does that teach you to kind of like just shake things off and move along?
Yeah, I have a thick skin.
Yeah, you kind of have to. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, over here. Oh, okay. Hey.
Yes, hi.
Hi.
I was wondering, with Stranger Things being so dark, was there ever a time on set where you were in the middle of a scene or on set and you were just completely creeped out on your own? I know there's all the cameras and all the set, that takes away from it, but you know, there's a lot of creepy.
Yeah. It's a creepy show, I'm not gonna lie. And I'm also not gonna lie about the fact that no, I didn't get creeped out because, like you said, there were people around, cameramen. It's hard to like act scared when then like right before you're supposed to be terrified for your life, there's someone behind you going, okay, you ready, Gaten?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm ready. With your left, a little bit. Good. Okay, ready? Yeah. Action. Get that scared mood.
It's like, yeah.
I like when the directors play like creepy music though, because that kind of gets you moving.
What kind of creepy music would they play? Do you remember?
They used to play like John Carpenter's chorus and everything.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, that'll get you in the mood. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, just like movie scores that were just unsettled.
Hi.
Hi.
For the show being set in the 80s and going into that, were you ever scared that you weren't gonna meet people's expectations for that?
Yeah. Oh. I love these questions, guys. No, I do. Thank you for all these amazing questions.
No, you say you're sorry.
I Yeah, you know, a lot of the back of my mind, people are gonna, I was always scared people were gonna give me crap. You are from the 80s.
Like, every time someone comes up to the booth, you are from the 80s.
The Duffers knew what they were doing. I didn't have to do it because, I mean, they gave us the prop, they gave us the script, gave us the clothes, so, like, watch these movies and listen to this music, and you are good. Like, okay, and I did, and I was good.
You know, honestly, it's not like we were doing, like, a real story about true kids, so, like, I wasn't so worried about that. I was actually just worried about the people who would like it. And because I identify with it, like you, you're not from the 80s, not that I know of, but, yeah. No, but it's just like, people just, yeah. So, I was just about to go into something else, I did not know what I was going to say, but yeah, so I wasn't really too worried about that. No problem.
What was your favorite sort of prop from the 80s that you guys liked interacting with?
My bike and my slingshot.
Those pretty good ones, yeah.
Yes. They're the things that we still have today.
Heckling comes from the audience, not from on stage.
No, go see.
No, I'm good. but like the walkie-talkie for cool, and
we still have those today as well. They use them on set all the time.
Actually, right?
Hey,
yeah. I'm sorry.